Hi, everyone, and welcome to our series of Jerry Lee Lewis stories. Today, our episode will focus on something many people never knew. So, on to our story. The Piano That Made Three Stars: How Jerry Lee Lewis, famous country singer Mickey Gilley, and televangelist Jimmy Swaggart learned to play on the same instrument. They are three of the most famous names in music history. Jerry Lee Lewis, the rock and roll pioneer known as The Killer; Mickey Gilley, the country singer and honky-tonk owner who inspired Urban Cowboy; and Jimmy Swaggart, the charismatic televangelist and gospel singer. But before they became stars, they were cousins who grew up together in the small town of Faraday, Louisiana, during the Great Depression, and they all learned to play on the same piano. That piano, an old Stark player piano, was carried in single-handed by Jerry Lee's father, Elmo, after Jerry Lee Lewis, at the age of 8, without ever having played before, picked out Silent Night on his aunt's piano after sitting on it for only a few minutes. His mother, Mamie, couldn't believe her ears and said, "My God, Elmo, he's a natural-born piano player." His parents then mortgaged their house to make sure Jerry Lee Lewis would have a chance to keep on practicing at home. It was a source of joy and escape for the young musician, who was exposed to a variety of musical influences, from gospel and country to blues and boogie-woogie. Jerry Lee Lewis was the first of three cousins to show his talent on the piano, playing by ear and mimicking the styles of his idols such as Al Jolson and Hank Williams. He was also the most rebellious and adventurous of the trio, often sneaking out to listen to the black music that was forbidden by his conservative family and the local mores. Within weeks or months, Jerry Lee developed his own wild and flamboyant style of playing and pounding the keys that would later make him a sensation in rock and roll and country music. Jimmy Swaggart, impressed by his cousin's talent, was the second cousin to join the piano sessions, and he was also the most religious. He was drawn to the gospel music that he heard in church and on the radio, and he sang with a fervor and passion that matched his preaching style. He also had a natural gift for playing the piano, and he taught himself how to read music and play chords. He was the one who encouraged his cousin, Mickey Gilley, to learn the piano as well. Mickey Gilley was the youngest and the most timid of the three. He had already taught himself how to play the guitar, but he wanted to learn the piano too. He asked Jimmy to show him some chords, and he practiced diligently until he mastered them. He was influenced by both Jerry Lee and Jimmy, but he also developed his own style of playing, blending country and pop with a smooth and polished touch. The three cousins played together on the Stark piano for many years, honing their skills and dreaming of fame. They also played in different bands and talent contests around Faraday and nearby towns, gaining experience and exposure. They eventually went their separate ways, pursuing their own musical careers and achieving remarkable success in their respective genres. But they never forgot their roots, and they always acknowledged the role that the Stark piano played in their lives. In 1949, Jerry Lee Lewis made his first public appearance as a musician outside of church. His father had heard about the grand opening of a new Ford dealership nearby, so he put the famous Stark piano on the back of a truck and drove Jerry Lee down there. Jerry Lee Lewis, aged 14 at the time, performed a rockin', drinkin' wine spodeody long before the world had ever heard of rock and roll and before it was ever invented. After he had finished, spectators there in awe of his young talent passed the hat and gathered $14. That was a lot of money for the dirt-poor Lewis family. This was the starting point of what had become one of the most successful, longest-enduring careers in the history of music, and inspired his cousins even more to follow their path. Mickey Gilley has sold millions of records as a country singer. Jimmy Lee Swaggart became one of the most powerful preachers of his time and a gospel music legend. And of course, we all know Jerry Lee Lewis kept entertaining the world with countless of hits until he was in his late 80s. All that thanks to this beat-up Stark Player piano. The piano itself is now a historical artifact displayed at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Museum in Cleveland, where visitors can see and touch the instrument that produced three legends. The piano is a testament to the power of music and the bond that it created among three cousins who shared a passion and a talent for playing the keys. Thank you for listening to part of our killer stories, and stay tuned for many more in the future.
Yes, there are many precious memories that I'd like to recall. And there are some things that I would surely like to forget. I've been up, Lord, I've been down. And sometimes just in between. But you know something, neighbors, I haven't reached my highest mountain yet. Yes, I know God's blessed me time and time and time again. And these blessings far exceed my deepest woe. I've had the help of loved ones and many friends who stood by me. And without their faith, I would have given up a long, long time ago. I remember my boyhood days back in Faraday, Louisiana. The long, hot summer and that cool Louisiana rain. You know, sometimes I wish I could go back and relive yesterday. Oh, Lord. And for a while, be mama's little boy again. You know, folks, the things that matter most in this whole world, money just can't buy. Sweet love, precious memories that will live on and on and on. And I remember, Lord, when I stumble, sometimes fall, I wonder why. Then I'll remember that I'll never, never, never walk alone. Yes, these are the things that matter most to me. Precious memories from your friend, Jerry Lee.